Hello class, today's topic is chapter 7, voidable contracts. So let's begin with the definition of a voidable contract. Remember, we already discussed this in passing when we discussed the introduction to defective contracts. So remember, in case of voidable contracts or annullable contract, it is defined by law as a valid contract. Why is it a valid contract? Because it possesses all the essential requisites. Remember, in a voidable contract, there is cause, there is also object, and there is consent. However, it is also defective. Why is it defective? Because it may be of one of two things. Number one, one of the parties is incapable of giving consent to the contract. Yun ang first na reason why the contract is defective. Or it can be another reason. Consent on the part of one of the contracting parties is vitiated by mistake, violence, intimidation, undue influence, or fraud. So yun ang kailangan yung tandaan in avoidable contract. So obviously, following from this definition, you will also realize that in case of avoidable contract, there is an injured party who is the minor, or who may be the, in case of vitiated consent, the person whose consent was vitiated. So minor, incapacitated person, or the person whose consent was vitiated. Sila yung injured party in avoidable contract. And also from the definition as well, we will also conclude that there is a guilty party. The guilty party is the person who violated yung consent ng isang kakontrata niya, or the person of legal age who took advantage of the incapacity of the other contracting party. So that is what you have to remember. There is a guilty party, there is an innocent party. And also, in voidable contracts, remember the injured or innocent party can ask for annulment or ratification of the voidable contract. Here's what you have to remember. A voidable contract, it remains valid. Kung pumasok ka sa isang voidable contract, afterwards, wala ka nang ginawa, pinabayaan mo lang siya, the contract will remain valid. Walang magiging problema. Kasi voidable contracts are contracts which are valid until they are annulled. Now, question, kailangan mo ba magpa-annul? Yes, kung gusto mo. But if ayaw mo, walang problema yan. Anyway, the contract will remain valid. So, para sa annulment, remember you have to go to court and file the proper court action. Also, remember that it is only the courts who can annul yung contract. Hindi natin pwedeng diskartehan yung sarili natin na, ay, annul ko na yung contract na to. Hindi pwede. It is the court who will decree annulment. What else? Also, yung voidable contract, remember that you can also ratify yung voidable contract. When you ratify, you adopt yung defective contract. So, parang hindi mo na ko-questionin yung kanyang defect. Once a contract is, voidable contract is ratified, remember, it will become absolutely valid and hindi ka na pwedeng magpa-annul. So, in voidable contract, kung hindi mo siya pinansin, pinabayaan mo lang, it will remain valid. Now, choice mo as an injured party whether you want to annul yung voidable contract or to ratify it. Pagka pina-annul mo, di mawawalang bisa yung voidable contract na yan. Pagka ni-ratify mo, remember also that the voidable contract will become valid and cannot be annulled anymore. So, obviously, these two, annulment and ratification, they are exclusive of one another. Once you choose one, hindi mo na pwedeng palitan yung napili mo. So, kung nag-ratify ka na, you cannot go to court and ask for annulment. If you go to court and ask for annulment, you cannot ratify the same contract. The next question to ask now, class, is kailangan ba ng ratification? As the injured party, remember, you have a choice whether or not you want to ratify a contract. Now, what is the effect kung hindi mo siya ni-ratify? There is actually no effect. The contract remains valid because avoidable contract is, again, a contract which is valid until it is annulled. Now, paano kung ni-ratify mo yung contract? If you choose to ratify a contract, remember, wine-waive mo lang yung right mo to ask for annulment in the future, because once ratified, again, a voidable contract becomes absolutely valid. What else? The kinds of voidable contracts. So remember, there are two kinds of voidable contracts. Number one, there is contracts where there is legal incapacity to give consent on the part of one of the contracting parties. The incapacity exists due to a minority or insanity or whatever other form of incapacity. What else? Number two, in case there is a violation of consent on the part of one of the contracting parties. Paano naman nagkakaroon ng violation of consent? If there is, remember, mistake, violence, intimidation, undue influence, or fraud. So remember your vices of consent. We already discussed that in chapter 2. Remember, bimfu. What else? Ratification. Again, in ratification, the party, the injured party, will voluntarily adopt a defective contract. So remember, plus in ratification, the contract is cleansed from its defect from the beginning. It is as if nung pumasok yung mga parties sa contract na ito, wala siyang defect kahit na ano. So parang pumasok sila hindi sa voidable contract, but pumasok sila sa valid contract. As if. What else? 1392 also, ratification will extinguish an action to annul a voidable contract. I've already discussed that. Choose one and yun lang ang pwede. What else? Number four, ratification may be affected expressly or impliedly. So remember, impliedly is by action. Also, ratification will not require the conformity of the guilty party. So hindi mo kailangan ng kanyang consent to ratify a voidable contract kung ikaw yung injured party. What else? In ratification also, you have to remember kung sino ang pwedeng mag-ratify. In a nutshell, very simple. The injured party. In case of incapacity, the guardian may ratify, or yun ngang injured party himself, provided he is already capacitated. So, in case of a minor, upon reaching the age of majority, pwede na siyang mag-ratify kung gusto niya. And also, in case of incapacitated persons, pagka they regained yung kanilang capacity, they can so ratify a voidable contract. What else? In case there is vitiation of consent, the injured party or the party whose consent is vitiated may ratify a contract later on. Also remember annulment. So again, ratification or annulment. Now if you choose annulment, as a side note class pala, in case of annulment, you only annul voidable contracts. You cannot annul rescissible contracts. In much the same way that you cannot rescind voidable contracts. So be careful of the terminologies that you use. Annulment is used only with respect to voidable contracts. Rescission is used only with respect to rescissible contracts. So what else you have to remember about annulment? Annulment is a remedy. Remember, for the declaration of the inefficacy of a contract due to a defect or vice in the consent of one of the contracting parties. And this is more important talaga. In order to restore them to their original position in which they were before the contract was executed. So, in annulment, remember, ibabalik yung mga parties sa kanilang original situation bago mangyari ang lahat ng iyon. Bago pumasok sa contract, ano ba ang itsura nila? Ibabalik sila doon. So, in annulment, there is a return to the status quo. So, yun ang kailangan nating tandaan sa annulment. Also, parties entitled to bring an action to annul. Very easy also. Injured party, who is a person who is interested in the contract, or a victim, yan, in case of vitiation of consent. What else also you have to remember about annulment is the prescriptive periods for filing an action for annulment. So in 1391, binigay dyan ang general rule. The prescriptive period for filing an action for annulment is 4 years. Bakit may prescriptive period? Bakit may limit? Yes, right yung mag-file ng annulment. Pero syempre, gusto ng law na magkaroon ng stability yung mga contracts natin. Hindi yung after 50 years, dun ka magde-decide na ipa-annul yung contract. At saka naman syempre, kung 50 years na yung nakaraan, is it not implied ratification on the part of the injured party na ganun katagal, tapos after 50 years, ganun, dun lang niya i-question. So remember, sabi ng law, right nyo, okay. But remember also that your right, meron niyang limit. You can exercise only in a certain number of years, which in this case is 4 years as a general rule. In 1391, period of prescription is modified or qualified pala. That is the better term. So in cases of intimidation, violence, or undue influence, remember, start counting 4 years from the time the intimidation, the violence, or the undue influence ceases. So maghintay ka muna. Pagka huminto na yung pananakot, huminto na yung pananakit, huminto na yung undue influence, remember, dun ka palang magsimulang magbilang ng 4 years. Kasi before that, remember, the consent is not yet free. What else? Also, number 2, in case of mistake or fraud, 4 years from the time it is discovered. Kailangan munang malaman ng injured party na injured party siya. That's why you cannot count it against him if he is not aware na meron palang fraud, meron palang mistake. Siyempre, hindi naman niya alam na niloloko siya. Kung alam niya na niloloko siya, di sana nag-file na siya ng action for annulment. So, if you will count the prescriptive period, please take note that it must be from the time of discovery. So, kahit na 10 years ago pa yung contract, if the injured party is not aware of the fraud or the mistake, it doesn't count. Hindi makakount. Mag-uumpisang bilangin yung prescriptive period na 4 years. What else? In case of contracts entered into by minors or other incapacitated persons, 4 years counted from the time the incapacity or the guardianship ceases. So, pagka natapos na yung incapacity or yung guardianship, they have 4 years. So, in case of a minor, very simple. Kailan ka magli-legal age? 18, 19, 20, 21, up to 22 years old. Exclude the first, include the last. So, remember, 19, hindi ka mag-umisa sa 18. 19, 20, 21, 22. 4 years to file an action for annulment. In addition to that, also remember, annulment requires also mutual restitution. Now, if you remember the definition of annulment a while ago, the second part, very important, as I've already said, there is an order to restore the parties to their original positions before the contract was entered into. Now, paano natin i-restore yung mga parties sa original positions? Remember, by mutual restitution. In mutual restitution, magbabalikan sila ng whatever they have received under the contract para magkaroon nga naman ng return doon sa original situation before nangyari ang lahat ng yan. So remember, in mutual restitution, is covered by Article 1398 and dalawang klase yan, subject to other rules which we will discuss later on. In a real obligation, the parties must restore to each other the subject matter of the contract and the price with legal interest. So remember, example na lang, let us say I am a minor, meron akong isang gold bracelet, naman ako yung gold bracelet ko. Tapos ikaw, person of legal age, dumating ka, tapos nakita mo yung bracelet ko, nagustuhan mo siya. Now you offered to buy my bracelet, gold bracelet, for what it's worth. So let us say, the value of my gold bracelet is, let us say, 200,000 pesos. So you offered to buy it for 200,000 pesos and pumayag ako. Now, question, what is the status of the contract here? Remember, kung ano yung value ng bracelet, yun ang binayad ng kausap ko. But even if that is the case, remember, the contract is still voidable. Hindi yan base sa value noong object. It is based on the fact that when I entered into the contract, I was incapacitated. So, voidable pa rin yan. Anyway, fast forward, I attained legal age. fast forward, I ask for annulment of this contract. Fast forward, there is a decree or order by the court para sa mutual restitution. So obviously, I have to return your money with legal interest. And also, you have to return yung subject matter of the contract, which is yung gold bracelet. So yun ang kailangan yung tandaan in case of mutual restitution. What else? Here, dito yung medyo tricky. What if your obligation is a personal one? So you rendered a service. Yan ang problema sa service. Once you render it, you cannot unrender it anymore. Babawiin mo yung service na nirender mo. Parang mahirap yon. Like as tinutukan mo ko ng barrel para kumanta ako. So, later on, pwede ko bang bawiin? Can I unsing yung song na kinanta ko? Hindi pwede. So remember, mahirap yon. Now, ano naman ang magiging basis ng mutual restitution dito? The basis here is damages, remember. So damages will be based on the value of the service rendered with corresponding interest. Babayaran niyan ng party who benefited from the service. In our example, yung party na nanutok ng barrel at tinakot ako para kumanta. So remember, that is mutual restitution under 1398. This is the general rule. This is subject to exception according to Article 1399 in case of an incapacitated person. So medyo tricky ang incapacitated person because remember, the incapacitated person is obliged to make restitution only to the extent that he was benefited by the thing or the price received by him. So in our example a while ago, again, the price received by the minor is 200,000 pesos and the object received by the person of legal age is yung gold bracelet. So anyway, minor, yung kanyang 200,000 na pera, anong ginawa niya? Yung 100,000, nag-weteng siya, tumaya siya sa weteng, nagsugal siya, bajong, bingo, pusoy dos, tong eats, etc., etc. Pinangsugal niya yung buong 100,000 pesos na yon. And yung 100,000 na balance, anong ginawa niya? Siya ay bumili ng basic necessities. Nagpunta siya sa supermarket, tapos siya ay nag-grocery. O, diba? So anyway, fast forward again. Person at a minor attains legal age, minor asks for annulment of the contract. Fast forward, court orders mutual restitution. Now, dun sa person of legal age or the guilty party, we have no problem. He must restore the gold bracelet, period. Now, what about the minor? Remember the rule in 1398, an exception to 1398. The rule is that he must return only to the extent he was benefited. In our example, he was benefited to the extent only of 100,000 pesos. Why? Yung 100,000 na pinang supermarket niya, pinang grocery niya, nag-benefit siya doon because of these are basic necessities. What else also? How about yung 100,000 na pinang sugal niya? Exactly, pinang sugal niya. So he squandered the proceeds of the sale. So itong portion na ito, hindi niya pinakinabangan. So anong ibabalik niya sa guilty party? Only 100,000 pesos. It might be unfair, but really, this is the risk na tinitake mo if you are a capacitated person contracting with an incapacitated person. There is always that risk. Kasi hindi mo naman talaga dapat pinasukan yung kontratang yan in the first place. What else also? In addition to that, annulment, effect of loss of the thing, 1,400, 1,401, and 1,402. In 1,400, remember, yung guilty party, siya yung nakawala ng object. So, nawala yung object na kailangan niyang ibalik. So, remember here, in our example, sige, ibayin na lang natin para medyo maganda. guilt minor, meron akong again gold bracelet, hindi ko pala kayang ibahin. So meron akong gold bracelet. Tapos ikaw naman, person of legal age, capacitated, meron kang gold necklace. Ayun na lang, medyo iba. So anyway, nagustuhan mo yung gold bracelet ko, sabi mo, swap tayo. So kukunin mo yung gold bracelet ko, makukuha ko naman yung gold necklace mo. So nag-swap tayo, nagpalitan tayo. Anyway, fast forward, minor attains legal age, minor asks for annulment of the contract, and again there is a decree of mutual restitution. So ako, I have to return yung, as an injured party, I have to return yung gold necklace mo. And also, you as the guilty party in the voidable contract, you have to return my gold bracelet. Now, what if yung gold bracelet that the guilty party is supposed to return is lost? So remember, loss here may occur in two ways. Number one, loss occurs without the fault of the person obliged to make the restitution, in which case the guilty party. So here, remember, there is no more obligation to return yung gold bracelet. Let us say yung gold bracelet nawala by a fortuitous event. Wala namang fault yung guilty party doon. Let us say, class, nahulog sa inagaw ng kabayo, tapos nilaglag niya sa kumunoy yung gold bracelet. So yun ang nangyari sa gold bracelet. Inagaw sa guilty party ng kabayo, tapos tsaka niya hinulog sa isang kumunoy. So the loss is by a fortuitous event. It is not the fault of the guilty party. So the rule in 1400 is the guilty party is no longer obliged to return the gold bracelet. But also, on the other hand, the innocent party who is supposed to return the gold necklace is no longer bound to restore yung kanyang yung gold necklace na na-receive niya, kasi hindi na rin naman niya matatanggap yung kapalit. So yun ang kailangan nating tandaan sa 1400. What about if the loss is through the fault of the guilty party? So again, yung example natin, yung gold bracelet na dapat ibabalik ng guilty party, anong ginawa niya? Binuhusan niya ng asido, tapos tsaka niya itinapon sa crater ng Mount Taal. Yan, Bulkang Taal. So yun ang ginawa niya. So remember here, the loss of the gold bracelet is by the fault of the guilty party. So anong mangyayari pagka nagkaroon na ng decree of mutual restitution? Hindi na niya kayang ibalik kasi sinira niya. But remember here, the obligation is not extinguished, but it is converted into an obligation to pay for damages, which will consist of the value of the object plus fruits plus interest at the time of loss. So walang katakas yung guilty party. Kasi number one, guilty na nga siya. Number two, sinira pa niya yung object na dapat niyang ibalik. So here really, there is bad faith on the part of the guilty party. That is the penalty that the law will impose upon him. Not only damages, value plus interest plus fruits. What else? Also, number in relation to that, what if it is the innocent party who loses the object which he is supposed to return? So here, the innocent party, remember in our example, is supposed to return what? Yung gold necklace belonging to the guilty party. Now, remember there are two rules here, 1401 and 1402. In 1401, sinasabi dyan na if the injured party hindi niya maibalik yung object because it is lost through his fraud or fault, remember, his right to have the contract annulled is extinguished. Kasi itong innocent party na ito is not so innocent at all. Bakit? Yung dapat niyang ibalik na gold necklace under the contract, anong ginawa niya? ano bang pwedeng gawin ng injured party. Ayun, minartilyo niya, tapos tsaka niya binuhusan ng asido hanggang sa natunaw, tapos nawala na. So anyway, hindi ko alam paano mangyayari yun, pero ganun nga, kasalanan niya. Bigla na lang nawala yung gold necklace. So anyway, dahil nga siya ang may kasalanan why the object which he is supposed to return is lost, remember that his right to have the contract annulled is extinguished because he cannot return through his fault. Now what if the loss is by a fortuitous event? Again, injured party is supposed to return the gold necklace, tapos yung gold necklace ay natamaan ng kidlat, tapos kinain ng mga alien, ganyan. So remember class, here papasok yung general rules of 1402. There is no annulment if he cannot restore what is bound to, but what he is bound to return. So parang pareho lang naman yung rules sa 1401 at saka 1402. Kasi in both cases, remember, if the whether or not the loss is through the fault of the injured party or not, if he cannot return, there is no annulment. Pero sabi ng mga authors, bigyan natin ng pag-asa yung innocent party kasi hindi naman niya kasalanan kung bakit nawala yung object. And remember also that in the voidable contract, siya yung innocent. So sabi ng mga authors, the innocent party can also ask for annulment, but he must offer yung value of the thing lost, pero hindi na niya kailangang bayaran yung interest because the loss here is by a fortuitous event. As applied to our example, ang mangyayari dyan, i-offer ng injured party the value of the necklace, but he does not have to pay for the interest. Bakit binigyan ng ganitong right? Kasi innocent sila. Malay nyo, itong injured party, may sentimental value pala yung necklace, ay yung bracelet na gusto niyang maibalik sa kanya. So remember, this is the rule for loss in case of on the part of the innocent party in case of mutual restitution. What else? Yun na pala yun. So anyway, that is all for chapter 7, voidable contracts. We will continue with chapter 8.